crowd in the streets of London the day the peace was signed. They sang in exultation, they danced, they whined, they dined. For the dreadful war was over, the slaughter at an end. And now at last a broken world can slowly start to mend. But among the celebrations, the cheerful, happy cries, a multitude were weeping. No laughter in their eyes. For these were no reason to share the festive mood. Their hearts were bowed with sorrow, their every cause subdued. For while the throng around them gave vent to shouts of joy, they grieved a loving husband, they mourned their precious boy. They thought of dads or brothers or cousins, nephews too, of uncles, colleagues, trusted friends, so many they knew.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Hooray! Hooray! Chant!
Stand up, Bert. Can you stand it?
On a memorial in Kohima, these words are inscribed. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
Standard bearers, order standard. Standard 8.
Why do you still march, old man, with medals on your chest? Why do you still grieve, old man, for those friends you laid to rest? Why do your eyes gleam, old man, when you hear those people flow? Tell me why you cry, old man, about those days so long ago. I'll tell you why I march, old man, with medals on my chest. I'll tell you why I grieve, young man, for those I lay to rest. Through misty fields of gossamer silk come visions of distant times, when boys of tender age lost lives and all their mothers pined. We buried them in a blanket shroud, their young flesh scorched and blackened. A communal grave, newly gouged, in blood-stained gores and bracken. And you ask me why I march, young man. I march to remind you all that but for those humble blossom youths, you'd never have known freedom at all.
Almighty God, we remember with thanksgiving those who made the supreme sacrifice for us in time of war. We pray that the offering of their lives may not have been in vain. By your grace, enable us this day to dedicate ourselves anew to the cause of justice, freedom, and peace. And give us the wisdom and strength to build a better world. For the honour and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We shall now say together the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Queen's representative, the Deputy Mayor of Sandwell, Councillor Sylvester, will now pray.
Lord King of West Bromwich will lay the wreath on behalf of our MP who has been called back to London.
Cool.
Major Ball. On behalf of the military police. Brigade Support. On behalf of the Royal Naval Association. On behalf of the Submariners Association. On behalf of the West Midlands Police. On behalf of West Midlands Fire Service. On behalf of the Sandwell Warden Service. If there are any other reads or tributes to place, please come forward now. The Queen's Royal Lancer. West Bromwich Air Cadets. Royal Army Service Corps Association. The British Red Cross. Friends of Dartmouth Park. The Royal Air Force Association. West Bromwich Civic Pride. Scouting and Guide Association. The Rotary Club West Bromwich. The former Royal British Legion Fire Park. On behalf of Sandwell House. Barbara West Bromwich. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war in times past and in recent months and weeks. Each one remembered by and known to God. Let us pray for those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss. Let us pray for all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. Let us pray for civilian men, women and children whose lives are disfigured by war or terror. Call into mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity. Let us pray for peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free. Let us pray for all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. And in this Jubilee year today, we give thanks for Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, for all she has done for this nation, and we ask for her continued health and wisdom. And we give thanks for our local leaders as they shape our communities and give themselves in the service of our local area. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. We will now sing our final hymn this morning, Now Thank We All Our God.
Thank you. Thank you.